trust that you do. I want to invite your attention to the time which is mine to first the Hebrew Bible or the Old Testament. The Old Testament, the book of Psalms. Psalm number 11. I want you to read verses 1 through 3. And while you are secure with that passage, I want to ask you to walk with me over to the New Testament, the Gospel according to Mark, chapter number 11. And I want to zero in on verse 22. Psalm number 11, verses 1 through 3. And then I want to invite you to the book of the Gospel according to Mark, St. Mark, chapter number 11, verse 22. You shall find it, say amen, and stand to your feet to honor this important reading of the Bible. Psalm number 11, reading from the New Revised Standard Version. In the Lord I take refuge. How can you say to me, flee like a bird to the mountains? For look, the wicked bend the bow. They have fitted their arrow to the string to shoot in the dark at an upright in heart. If the foundations are destroyed, what can the righteous do? Say that a different way. When everything I trust in is being destroyed, what will the faithful do? Mark 11. Jesus answered them, have faith in God. Truly I tell you, if you say to this mountain, be taken up and thrown into the sea, and you do not doubt in your heart, but believe what you say will come to pass, it will be done. Amen. I want to preach for about 15 minutes on this first Sunday from the subject, faith to face it. Faith to face it. Let's go to God in prayer. Father, what I am, you are. What I know, you taught me. What I have, you gave me. What I am, Lord, you made. Lord, I am depending on you. Can't do nothing till you come. This is your servant's prayer. I ask it in Jesus' name. And all God's children said, amen. Turn and tell somebody, neighbor, you got to have faith to face it. Turn and tell somebody, neighbor, I pray your faith helps you face it. Give God a praise. We all know that David asked King of Israel was a masterful songwriter. His book of Psalms give us the bulk of the book of Psalms in our Bible. Psalm number 11 is not necessarily one that all of us memorize, but it's one, if you keep living, you ought to know. The psalm is written in the context of difficulty. And the psalm raises a question that people of faith had to answer then, and we have to answer now. David is going through something. Some suggest that he is on the run from King Saul. Others suggest that perhaps he is facing a crisis that we don't know about. But David called on some folk to get their advice on what he ought to do. Have you ever called on somebody to help you understand what your options are? David called on advisors, and one after the other looked at the situation and gave the same answer. David, if I were you, I'd get up out of here because this is too much to handle. David, I would you, I would run. They gave you two options. Well, we have two options. Running. Amen. You can either run to the mountains, hide out, or you can run away, which suggests you're not necessarily going anywhere in particular, but you're just getting up out of here. Are y'all here? David was facing a crisis. David had been given some options, and the options involved running. Now I know y'all are strong. And I know when problems come your way, when crises show up, when the very things you trust in are being dismantled, I know you all are always given sound advice, and the wisdom that others give you are far from the wisdom they receive. Y'all know this guy, right? One of our first reactions to difficulty is to run. Are y'all here? Y'all better talk to me. You run to another place. When problems are bad here, you run over there. God's not going to talk to you. When you have problems in this job, you run to another job. Y'all not going to help me. When you have problems with this relationship, you run to another relationship. Y'all don't want to talk. I'm going to let y'all know because y'all are getting back this. Yeah, you run to something else. But I've got to open up now to know that running to isn't always the best option. You ever heard the story or the saying, the grass is greener on the other side? That most times if the grass is greener, it's because the picture's been altered. And when you get to, you realize the same stuff that you left is the same stuff that you got. Seven, grandma said that's what you call jumping out of the frying pan. You run to another location. Problems come and our very foundations are being dismantled. We'll run away. And that's even worse than running to. At least running to, you have a plan. Running away, you just going anywhere but here. Preach, boy! There's no strategy. There's no thoughtfulness. There's no strategic look at stuff. You just get up and go. Because you just run away. I want to tell you, the reality of it is that when the things we trust in are dismantled, when the stuff we put our trust in begins to crumble, I want to tell you, sometimes we hear and we do run to or run away, but not David. David sat down and began to think about this a little bit. David thought to himself, maybe he thought, I'm too old to run to and too proud to run away. Somebody gonna get that. David said, no, what am I going to run? He said, what I'm going to do in the Lord, I'm going to take refuge. What he's saying is, when times are hard, my very trust is being shaken with me. My foundations are crumbling before me with me. The very infrastructure that holds me up when there be like a bird. Well, I don't fly somewhere. you know, sure, he's right. I wish he wouldn't be so plain, but he is right. My mama showed me something in life. She showed me that life ain't always good. Things don't always work out the way you want. But you got to learn how to deal with the stuff you face. You got to spread your shoulders. You got to look at it. And you got to tell yourself, I'm not scared. Because I just got nervous. Y'all know what I'm talking about. I'm driving and I see 6 and 7 lanes and folks driving crazy. So I would always get somewhere between Macon and Atlanta coming from the south, or somewhere past outside of Marietta coming to the south. And I would get nervous. I'd tense up. Someone told me, Cliff, here's what you do. Don't worry about that. What you do, you bypass it. You take the bypass and you get around all that. Don't worry about it. So for years, I took the bypass. Then one day, true story, not lying, something just said, what you scared of? Go on through downtown. And guess what I found out? When I went through downtown, there was less traffic going through than you had going around. Y'all missed that. I found my journey was easier when I faced my fear and then bypass my fear looking for an easy way out. I'm trying to help somebody here. I don't know what you're facing right now, but I tell you to stop trying to run away from it, but to stay where you are. Have faith in God, because God will see you through. I know it's right. I know we're living in a time in our country. We're watching foundations crumble. How is it possible that 3 million people in Puerto Rico, a U.S. territory where taxes are paid, have been begging for clean water and electricity, while the leader of the free world sits his tail at a golf resort and has the gall to talk to a female as he talks to his own wife, not respecting anybody. I tell you, foundations are being dismantled. I'm not one that believes in the American myth of exceptional country. I'm not one that believes America's history has always been good. You just look at how this country got started. You would know for yourself that it wasn't started on the right foundation. You look at how they treated Native Americans. You look at how they treated our ancestors who were slaves. not easy. And I know that many of us have a lot we're facing. But face it. Don't run from it. You got what you need to get through. Stop hiding. Stop running away. Stop pretending it doesn't exist. You got faith. And faith is all you need. You got faith. And faith is a power that can do for you and this country and this world what needs to be done. Stop running away. Stop hiding out under a rock. Stop pretending problems don't exist. Have faith in God. If your faith is only good for your personal satisfaction, and your faith cannot speak to the problems of a society that needs justice, your faith is weak and it's not the faith of our Savior. Because our Savior understood that faith was a power that can upset the natural order and turn things around. Listen to what he told his disciples. Have faith in God. Because if you have faith, you can speak to a mountain and tell it to get up and be cast into the sea. And the mountain will get feet and creep over to the sea and jump off in the water and get out of your way. I want to tell you, for our Savior, faith was a power that can turn things around. I want to tell you right now, when all you got left is faith, stand in your faith.
In God.